Thank you. God calls us to worship with these words from Psalm 117.
Praise the Lord, all you nations.
Extol him, all you peoples.
For the Lord, great is our Lord, his steadfast love towards us.
And the faithfulness of the Lord endures forever.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
que quitas los pecados del mundo, atiende nuestras súplicas, porque reinas con el Padre. Ten piedad de nosotros.
A reading from 1 John chapter 4. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealed among us in this way. God sent God's only Son into the world so that we might live through him. Beloved, since God loved us so much, we ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God lives in us, and God's love is perfected in us. We love because he first loved us. Those who say, I love God, and hate their brothers or sisters are liars. For those who do not love a brother or sister whom they have seen cannot love God whom they have not seen. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Join me in this prayer of lament from Our World Belongs to God, a contemporary testimony of the Christian Reformed Church. We grieve that the church, which shares one spirit, one faith, one hope, and spans all time, place, race, and language, has become a broken communion in a broken world. When we struggle for the truth of the gospel and for the righteousness God demands, we pray for wisdom and courage. When our pride or blindness hinders the unity of God's household, we seek forgiveness. We marvel that the Lord gathers the broken pieces to do his work, and that he blesses us still with joy, new members, and with surprising evidences of unity. We commit ourselves to seeking and expressing the oneness of all who follow Jesus, and we pray for brothers and sisters who suffer for the faith.
Thank you.
You may be seated. Hear now these words of the church about being united in Christ. First, from the Heidelberg Catechism. What do you believe concerning the Holy Catholic Church? I believe that the Son of God, through his word and spirit, out of the entire human race, from the beginning of the world to its end, gathers, protects, and preserves for himself a community chosen for eternal life and united in true faith. And of this community, I am and always will be a living member.
Now, from the Catechism of the Roman Catholic Church. The Church is both the means and the goal of God's plan, prefigured in creation, prepared for in the Old Covenant, founded by the words and actions of Jesus Christ, fulfilled by his redeeming cross and his resurrection. The Church has been manifested as the mystery of salvation by the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. She will be perfected in the glory of heaven as the assembly of all the redeemed of the earth.
And from Martin Luther's Catechism, I believe that there is upon earth a little holy group and congregation of pure saints, under one head, even Christ, called together by the Holy Ghost in one faith, one mind, and understanding, with manifold gifts, yet agreeing in love, without sects or schisms.
From the Belhar Confession of the United Reformed Churches in South Africa, we believe that this unity must become visible so that the world may believe that separation, enmity, and hatred between people and groups is sin, which Christ has already conquered, and accordingly that anything which threatens this unity may have no place in the church and must be resisted. And now from Psalm 133, how good and pleasant it is when God's people live.
To live.
Together.
Together in unity.
How good and pleasant it is when God's people live together in unity. Miren que bueno.
Miren qué bueno, qué bueno es.
Miren qué bueno es.
Miren qué bueno es cuando los hermanos estamos juntos. Miren qué bueno, qué bueno es.
Miren qué bueno, qué bueno es.
Miren qué bueno es cuando las hermanas están juntas.
Miren
reading from Matthew 5.
Jesus said, "You are the light of the world.
A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand.
And it gives us light into all in the house.
In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works.
And give glory to our Father in heaven."
And now there will be a call and response.
You'll see the words to the call and response printed in your liturgy. Please join us on the response.
Thank you.
My God, how great thou art. Amen? Would you join me in a prayer? We bow, Lord, in humble adoration. And we proclaim how great you are. We are grateful for your majesty, your power, your blessings. And we look forward to the day when all people will worship you together. We embrace the words of John the Revelator, who said, "After this I looked, and there before me was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, every tribe, every people, every language, standing before the throne and before the Lamb. They were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands." Lord, we are ready to join the throng, to put on those robes, to wave those branches. We are here, Lord, from all nations, and we bless you. Thanksgiving and honor be to you forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
May the love of the Lord, the music of these choirs, and the words we have spoken together tonight spur us on as we leave this place, so that we may act justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with our God.
Go in peace to love and serve the
to love and serve
to the love and serve the Lord.
Amen.